Hi dear students, today we are going to again continue with the topic of the chapter biomolecules. We talked about the introduction of the carbohydrates. Now we are going to talk about the classification of the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates can be mainly monosaccharide, oligosaccharide and polysaccharides. We are going to see in detail one by one. Monosaccharides, dear students, monosaccharides are the simple format of the polyhydroxyaldehyde or polyhydroxyketone. They cannot be further hydrolyzed. So we have the example of glucose and fructose. One is the example of aldose, one is example of ketose. Also we have the examples of glucose, fructose, arabinose and ribose. Second, oligosaccharide. Dear student, you are able to see oligosaccharide is having a long chain connected with each other. And when it can be cleaved over there, it is going to give you number of monosaccharides. So oligosaccharides is made up of large units of the monosaccharides. Here we go for having disaccharide example, trisaccharides, tetrasaccharides. So disaccharide is made up of two monomers. You can say that there are two particular monosaccharides which cannot be further hydrolyzed. It can be hydrolyzed only once. So disaccharides, first of all, we are going to see. Disaccharides are made up of two monosaccharides, as I told you just now. See, we are taking the example of sucrose and maltose. Sucrose is made up of glucose and fructose. They are connected together and when they are cleaved, are you able to see when the hydrolysis is taking place, we are getting one part of glucose, another part of fructose. Similarly, maltose is made up of two particles of glucose. So we can say that when we go for hydrolysis of the disaccharides, we are gaining ultimately monosaccharides. Now they cannot be further hydrolyzed. The another example, that is trisaccharides. Now here in what will be the example, dear students? Raffinose. Raffinose and styrose is the example over here. So they will be giving you three monosaccharides. Polysaccharides yields a large number of the monosaccharide units when hydrolyzed. So when the cleavage takes place over there here, polysaccharides yields a large number of monosaccharides unit. Our best examples are starch, cellulose and glycogen. They are also called non-sugars because they do not give the sweet taste. They are not sweet in taste. So we can say that these are the non-sugars. Dear student, always remember monosaccharides and oligosaccharides are the sugars. They are carbohydrates that have the sweet taste. But polysaccharides are not giving the sweet taste. Carbohydrates, as we can classify them as a reducing sugar, non-reducing sugar. So dear student, they will be giving the valine test and they will be giving the tolerance test. And on the same side, non-reducing sugars are not going to give you the valine test and it is not going to give the tolerance test. Valine and tolerance test conclusion. Sucrose is disaccharides and it is a non-reducing sugar. Valine test is not given by this particular. Disaccharides are reducing sugar, but only the sucrose is the one which is disaccharide. Still it is non-reducing sugar. Okay, monosaccharides, how do we name them? Naming about them is depending on the which group, functional group is present, aldose or ketose. Dear student, you are able to see according to the number of the carbons, we are having tri, tetra, penta, hexa, hepta. And also along with that, we go for having OSE. Now it is going to depend, we have aldehyde or ketone. Suppose if we go for having 6 carbons, we are going to say hexose. If aldose is present, we will say aldohexose. And as here the example, we have ketone, we will say it is a ketohexose. Similarly, you can try a number.